I think he's a three really good friend I have in the MotoGP. Tony is something special, you know. From long time, from more than 10 years, I know him.
Fabio Quartararo, who's bosom buddies with Tony Arbolino. I think they spent a bit of time training together in California during that long winter break.
Tony is the guy that is the only one that handle me, and I handle him.
I asked him to meet because I feel good to talk with him, and he's the only rider that I can talk with.
I can see straight away if he's stressed, motivated. Depend how I see his face, I tell him one thing or another.
Maybe when I am a bit stressed, a bit not under control, the things he come, and if I meet him, I'm just more relaxed.
Moto2 World Championship leader in 2023 as Tony Arbolino wins here in France.
With Jake also in 2020, we had a really great connection. I always try to keep him calm.
No, I'm better now. I was stressed earlier. I went to Pompa just a minute ago to grab a banana. The wind is stronger. Also down the hill in two.
If you have a problem, you can talk to each other. So yeah, it's nice, and it's just nice to have someone that's friendly in the paddock.
As those two, they are very, very close mates.
And Ayumu, same. You know, he was in Petronas, and I love him so much. So hopefully he can fight for the title.
From then we've been good friends, and now that being close friend also with Jake Dixon, we motivate each other.
I'm not really in position to give them advice, you know, and every rider is different.
It's more about giving each other a confidence, more than like advice on riding style.
It's not because I'm in MotoGP that I know the more, and you know, people from outside can tell you many things, and I think it always help.
Definitely their help is massive for me.
We contact each other when we feel we need to contact each other.
I think it's a great atmosphere and great energy between us.
I hope also when we retire both, we can enjoy a bit more this relationship.